Investigators combed through it Sunday night looking for clues. A wrecker took it to the crime lab to look for hair, fibers, anything that might lead to the attacker. Police say in the parking lot of Freelon's Bar Saturday about 4 in the morning, a gunman forced a woman to drive to a parking garage in downtown Jackson. Police say he raped her in the back seat and then threw her in the trunk and drove to this apartment complex. Police say that man pulled up in this parking lot and opened up the trunk. That's when the girl got out and ran to this building, number 3, and banged on doors for neighbors' help. Police say one of them took her to the hospital.
Grace of God, she did not get the right door, and somebody answered it, came to and was able to help her and, you know, give her assistance to wherever she needed to.
It just rubbed me because, you know, I got children and I fear for others and anything could happen.
Neighbors say it is a disturbing reminder of another violent crime that occurred not far away. This apartment complex backs up to the woods where investigators found Latasha Norman's body. A jury convicted her ex-boyfriend, Stanley Cole Jr., of killing the former JSU student.
You have to just kind of be able to look out and try to help each other if you can.
Investigators are hoping what they find in this car will help them catch a rapist. Catherine Kite, 16 WAPT News.
Investigators may also be counting on state capitol police for help in this case. One officer may have actually stopped the suspect and questioned him, but let him go because there was no signs of foul play. Police described the suspect as a black male, 5'5". He was wearing an orange hoodie and blue jeans at the time. If you have any information about this case, there's a reward for you. You can call Crime Stoppers at 601-355-TIPS. We could find out Friday if that jawbone found in Aruba belonged to Natalie Holloway. It was found on an Aruban beach last week. The 18-year-old former Clinton resident disappeared 5 years ago. Holloway's dental records were sent to the Forensic Institute Wednesday, according to the FBI. She was last seen on that island leaving a nightclub with Joran Vandersloot and two other men. He is now awaiting trial in Peru on a murder charge. Commitment 2010 coverage continues.